हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो इन टुडेज टॉपिक ऑफ प्रेजेंटेशन वी आर गोइंग टू कवर पैसिव कंपोनेंट इंडक्टर फ्रॉम चैप्टर 1 इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कंपोनेंट्स एंड सिग्नल्स फ्रॉम सब्जेक्ट बेसिक इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स 2225। सो इंडक्टर, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट इंडक्टर। It is a passive component. That can store energy in magnetic field. Now, capacitor was a component that used to store store the energy in electrical form, and the inductor stores the energy in magnetic form. Magnetic form created by electric current passing through it. Its unit is Henry, denoted by H. And here are the pictures of the actual inductors. So you can see here. So inductors look like this. There are some wires wound on it. So these are the inductor. Practically available value will be in terms of micro Henry and milli Henry. So basically the value of the inductors will be in micro Henry or milli Henry. Like capacitor, inductors temporarily store energy, so it is a temporary storage. A capacitor also store it temporary, so it first charges and discharges. Types of inductance, there you get different types of inductance. Are there self inductance and mutual inductance. Now the working of the how the inductance. The magnetic field is formed. You can see here. Inductor stores energy in a magnetic field, not an electric field. It passes DC, blocks AC. Now it is exactly opposite to that of capacitor. Both are complementary. Capacitor passes AC and blocks DC, and this inductor passes DC and blocks AC. So inductor likes DC. So along with Henry, inductance is abbreviated in terms of current also. Now how the inductors are manufactured or fabricated? It is a coil of wire. So while is a conducting material, coil of wire which can be wound on air or on a magnetic material. So magnetic material is there. Magnet is there, and on that this conducting wire is wound, as shown here. You can see here. So how the conducting wires are wound, you can see here. So like this, it is a coil of wire which can be wound on air or magnetic material. The number of factors affecting the inductance value, and that forms the inductor. Now what are the different factors that affects the inductance value? It the number of coil turns. So how much time that wire is wound around that magnetic material, depending upon that number, how much thick that wire is wounded, it depends on that. Then the diameter of the coil, spacing between the turns, size of the wire used, and type of the material inside the coil. So these are the different factors which affect the inductance value. So here you can see the different types of inductors which are available in the market. So these are all different types of inductors. So in types of inductors, there are two types. One is fixed type. So fixed types of inductors are the inductors whose value does not change. So if the value is 10 millihenry, so it will be always 10 millihenry. You cannot change the value of the inductor. You have to put that inductor in the circuit, then it will remain the same. You cannot change it. And the symbol of the inductors are also shown here. So in fixed type there are two types: air wound inductors and toroidal inductors. So here the round one are called as toroidal inductors. So air wound inductor symbol is shown here, and the toroidal inductor symbol is also shown here. That is ferrite core inductor. So these are the different inductors. Axial power inductors, it looks like resistor, but you can see there are no color bands on it. Yes, there are color bands in that first lower inductor you can see. So but it looks like resistor, but it is not resistor, it is an inductor. Then you have SMD power inductor, bead inductors. Category of inductor is variable inductor. Now these are the inductors whose value can be changed. So if you want to change the value in this circuit, you can change. In the other circuit, you want some other value, you can change. You can do it. And that is called as variable inductor. So here you have shown that variable inductors, how it looks. And that variable inductor symbol is also shown here, preset inductor. So this is about the variable inductor. Now the application of the inductors. Inductors are used in many circuits. Only two I have here listed here, the tuner circuit, impedance matching, and many more it is there, right? The whole thing, whole most of the applications you need inductor, capacitor, resistor. Now this was all about the passive components. So we have covered the resistor, then we have covered the capacitor, and now we have covered the inductor. So now we will move on to the next category of electronic components, that was active components. So if you remember about the active components, they can generate energy. So the active components definition: if a component have inner capacity to change the energy format from one form to another, then it is known as active components. Its action can be controlled and it requires external source to work. All semiconductors devices like diode, transistor, etc. These are the names of the active components. Diode, transistor, IC, these are all active components. Now here some of the active components are also shown here. So we will talk about the active component diode. So it is a two terminal device. It is made up of semiconductors, p-type and n-type of semiconductor. So you must be knowing about the semiconductors. Their semiconductors are classified as intrinsic semiconductor and extrinsic semiconductor. Intrinsic semiconductors are pure semiconductors. And extrinsic semiconductors are the semiconductors in which some impurities are added. That adding impurity is called as doping. So out of that you get two type of extrinsic semiconductor. One is p-type and one is n-type. And the diodes are formed using p-type and n-type when are connected together. When both are semiconductors are connected together, then a p-n junction diode is formed. It is having two terminals. One terminal is called as anode and the other is called as cathode. So here the symbol of the diode is shown. You can see with the arrow and a straight line. That arrow side terminal is anode and the straight line is side terminal is called as cathode. So you get different types of diodes in the market. You get p-n junction diode, which is a normal diode. Then you get signal diode, Zener diode, photodiode, light emitting diode, Schottky diode, studs, etc. So the symbol of the diode is shown here. And this is the actual black color diode which you can find in the laboratory, which we'll be using in the laboratory. And these red color diodes are Zener diodes, which this is how it looks. And the Zener diode symbol is shown here. You can see it is not having a straight line on the cathode side, but little Z type structure. Then signal diodes are shown. Signal diodes look like this and the symbol is here. Then your light emitting diode. Now this light emitting diodes, these are the colorful lights which you get, but they are not lights, they are light emitting diodes. So the symbol of the light emitting diode is shown. The arrow is showing outward because light is coming out of this diode. So the light emitting diode we will study in detail. So when the device is forward, now light emitting diode, when the device is forward biased, electrons cross the p-n junction from the n-type material and recombine with the holes in the p-type material. So as you know, as I told you, the diodes are formed by connecting n-type and p-type of semiconductor together. So when n-type and p-type of semiconductor are connected, so n-type is having majority carriers as electrons and p-type majority carrier holes, and they travel, n-type majority carriers travel from n to p and p-type majority carriers travel from p to n because they are attracted, and then a depletion layer is formed at the center. Now since the electrons in the conduction band area are at a higher energy level than the holes in the valence band, then the recombination takes place. So when the recombination takes place, electrons and holes recombine, energy is released in the form of light and little in the heat, but mostly in the light. So what, when they combine, light is coming out. A large exposed surface on one layer of the LED permits a photon to be emitted as light, termed as electroluminance. So here you can see, I've shown you how the light is coming out. So upper one is p-type of semiconductor, down one is n-type of semiconductor. The black dots are nothing but the electrons, and that white dots are holes. And when the electrons and holes recombine, a light is coming out. That is how the LED gives us the light. Symbol of LED is shown here. So arrow is anode and the straight line is cathode, and the light is coming out is shown by two arrows. Then the next active component is transistor. So it is a three terminal device. We will study transistor in details in next coming chapters. So but only what you have to remember, it is a three terminal device. It is actually manufactured using semiconductors only. So there are basically two types of extrinsic semiconductors, n-type and p-type. So when n-type, between two n-type semiconductors, if p-type is sandwiched, that means n-type semiconductor, then p-type is semiconductor is connected, and again on that semiconductor, if n-type is connected, a three-layer structure of semiconductor is formed. That is called as NPN transistor. And if p-type semiconductor, then n-type semiconductor is put on the p-type slab, and then again p-type is put on the n-type of semiconductor, that total combination becomes an NPN transistor. So actual transistor is shown here, and the symbol of the transistor is also shown here. Now we'll study about the energy sources. Now we have studied about the, so we have studied about the what is called as passive components and active components. We have defined passive components, active components. Now for all these components, you need something, some energy source to give, so that they can work, and that energy sources we are going to study. So different types of energy sources are there. One is voltage source, other is current source. You must be knowing, actually the definition is completely dependent upon what you say or how it has been classified. So there are different sort of classification here. You can see energy source are classified as independent source or dependent source. This is one sort of classification. Second classification is voltage source or current source, because in when you form a circuit, you need to give some source, voltage source or current source, so that it can work. So these are, these energy sources are very important. Then it can also be classified as DC source or AC source. Now we have already studied about DC signal and AC signal. So if that source is supplying DC signal, then it is DC source, and if it is supplying AC signal, then it is called as AC source. Then ideal source or practical source. So we'll study that in details. So first here, this is independent ideal voltage source. So this is the source. Now here load, the circuit diagram, the diagram which you'll see, the load is the whole circuit, that and that circuit is connected to a voltage source. It is the symbol of the voltage source which is shown here. It doesn't look like this. So voltage source, that means it will supply a voltage to the given circuit. It doesn't mean they does not supply current, but it will supply a fixed voltage to the load. The source determines the voltage, so that voltage source will determine the voltage, but the current is determined by the load. So load will decide the current, how much current will flow through the circuit. The source has zero internal resistance. Now if it is ideal voltage source, it is having zero internal resistance. For example, the voltage source is of 6 volts, so exact 6 volts should be supplied to the load. But sometimes what happens, you get 5.98 voltage. Maybe that lack, that less voltage is maybe due to some decrease in the voltage due to internal resistance. So if you consider an ideal voltage source, so we consider that there is no resistance and complete voltage is applied to the load. So some symbols of the voltage source are shown here. Ideal DC voltage source. So this voltage source will supply voltage, but that will be a DC voltage. Then the ideal AC voltage source will supply AC signal, and that is shown like this. And then the battery which you connect to the load or the circuit is shown like this, as shown in the figure C. So this was all about the voltage source. Now we are going to work out what is current source. So current source will supply the current to the circuit or to the load. Here it is shown, and the current source is shown like this, as shown in the figure. And here also, if it is independent ideal current source, then the internal resistance is considered to be zero. Here these are the symbols of the DC current source, and if it is a AC current source, then it is shown in figure B. You can see. Now we have done the ideal voltage source and the current source, but practically ideal and voltage current source doesn't exist. Like there is a bit change of voltage, little decrease in voltage. So we'll talk about now practical voltage source. So it is represented by an ideal voltage source in series with an internal resistance. So here some resistance is there considered inside the ideal voltage. So it is an ideal voltage source along with the internal resistance. So here you can see in circuit A the voltage source Vs, and there here up you can see internal resistance. So that total becomes your source, and then is connected the load to it. Then we'll talk about the practical current source. Now here the practical current source is ideal current source with internal resistance, but here the internal resistance is connected in parallel with the practical current source. You can see here in figure A the source Is and the internal resistance is connected in parallel, RS1, and that is connected to the whole voltage source, current source is connected to the load. Now we'll study about the source transformation. A practical current source can be converted into its equivalent practical voltage source and vice versa. So if you are having a current source, you can convert it into voltage source, and voltage source can be converted into current source. This conversion is only valid for the external load connected across the terminals of the source. So here you can see. So if the voltage source is there, you can see Vs above, and then the Rs is the internal resistance of the source. So this is the source, and the load resistor is RL, RL is called as a load resistor. So that is the load or the circuit that can be converted into current source as shown here in the circuit. So IS is the current source and that RS is connected in parallel. So that is how the voltage source is connected, converted into current source. So this was all about the different types of energy sources and the conversion. Thank you.